What's up, ladies and gents? This is Casey Kid coming at you with another Destiny video. Today, we're taking an exotic look at the Dragon's Breath rocket launcher, the brand new Dragon's Breath rocket launcher for year 2 in the Taken King. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and smack that like button and subscribe to the channel. So one of the earliest videos we did here was an exotic review of the Dragon's Breath. It was coming out for the Dark Below. Everybody was looking forward to it. Everybody was hoping that it was going to be an extremely powerful rocket launcher. So I got the weapon, I leveled it up, I thought, boy, I want to try this and show everybody what it's all about. And my opinions were that it was not very good, and that really wasn't very popular with some people, because everybody had really high hopes for this, but it was pretty bad. And I wanted to come check out the Dragon's Breath in the year 1 kiosk, just to see if it was still a year 1 Dragon's Breath, or if they retrofitted it. And it looks like they did change it, so the perks that you have are actually all the year 2 perks, so you don't actually get to see how bad this weapon used to be, even if you get it in year 1. Though of course the skill tree looks very different than it does right now. But basically this is the same exact weapon in year 1 and year 2, there is no change to it. But we actually need to take a look at it to see what is different about this weapon than what it previously used to be. First off, the biggest thing is the napalm perk. This is exactly what I was hoping for whenever Dragon's Breath first came out. Instead, we used to shoot out a solar grenade that enemies simply avoided and didn't run into and was pretty much useless. Now, whenever you fire off this weapon, you shoot a lake of fire that enemies actually stand in and can walk in and get damaged by. So that's a really good thing. If I shoot off a rocket, I want it to kill things. We also have surplus. That means whenever you find your purple bricks on the ground, you're going to get more heavy ammo from them. So that is always a good perk. Finally, you could pick between javelin and speed reload. I had javelin on earlier, but I just swapped over to speed reload just to see if it makes a difference. I don't know that it really does. Who's next? I believe this kill will only work, and this perk will only proc whenever you actually get a kill with the actual rocket, not the burn damage from the fire. But still, anything to help your reload a little bit since you only have one rocket at a time is going to be useful. Now to test it out, we're just going to go into the Court of Orcs. This is Kruger on the reciprocal runes, so not really too difficult, but I wanted to see if I could potentially kill him with one rocket. I didn't, but let's take a look and see where his health actually is. Whenever we get back into the arena, you can see that one Dragon's Breath nearly took him out. Nearly completely took him out. So if we end up killing one more Cursed Thrall and then we can shoot him again, this should pretty much destroy Kruger. So not bad at all. That is pretty powerful. Far more powerful than in year 1. Over here we have little baby Crota on the antiquated runes. And I fired off the Dragon's Breath and look at that. The Dragon's Breath alone pretty much can take him to a knee. So that's actually a pretty significant improvement, because remember whenever we were doing Crota, back whenever we were doing his raid, everybody was like, Yallahorn or bust. But the fact that you can use this Dragon's Breath and little baby Crota kind of sticks in the pool of fire and he walks around in it and he constantly takes damage over time, that's one of the big keys to why this is actually really good, because he's constantly taking damage over time, which means that his shield isn't regenerating. A really good thing. Also, one other thing I didn't mention yet on this gun is the extra ability with the firing trigger. So with rockets, if you don't hit the enemy directly, you're going to miss your rocket. So you can do two things. You can kind of aim towards the ground or a wall and get the explosion off of that. Or with the Dragon's Breath, if you hold down the trigger whenever you fire, you're basically remotely setting up your rocket to explode. And whenever you release your trigger, your rocket will explode. You will drop your napalm canister then after that. So if you get into a habit of holding down the trigger and then releasing it when it's around an enemy, you can at least hit the enemies and deal out the damage that way. Or if you're like me, you kind of shoot towards the ground a lot more and you don't use that often. But if you ever want to deal out damage to something like a witch or a wizard, having that extra ability is going to help out a whole lot. So overall, I like this gun a whole lot. It is a significant improvement of where it sat in year 1. It's not something that you're going to be carrying around all the time like you would with a Yallahorn, but whenever you're having some fun in PvE, or maybe you want to have a little bit of fun in control on PvP, I think it's going to show some versatility there. The surplus never hurts in PvE, and just being able to deal out a lot of damage to a lot of enemies at once and have a little bit of crowd control is always a nice thing. So I would say Dragon's Breath, if you can get it, use it, try it out. Let me know what you think about it if you do have the gun already. So that is it. Year 2 Dragon's Breath, better than year 1. If you enjoyed this video, smack that like button and subscribe to the channel. Check out these awesome videos. Good luck with your raids, your drops, your Dragon's Breath, and I'll see you around in Destiny. It's Napalm on the Dreadnought.